Hey everyone, I hope this video finds you happy, healthy, grounded, and centered. Here we are, it is the end of May, we are moving into June, and I asked the guides this morning for a few words on the energies that we're moving into and what they thought we needed to focus on. And if you've been following any of the channelings from the guides for a while, really the last 10, 11 months, they have been talking about this coming solstice, the end of June, beginning of July. They said it's going to be very intense for people on the planet. So without further ado, here is the ninth dimensional Pleiadian collective to share their perspective. Ah yes, hello dears, this is the Ninth Dimensional Pleiadian Collective and it is a pleasure and an honor to have the opportunity to connect with you. So today we want to talk to you about maintenance of frequency. And you know, Wendy asked us earlier about what we thought you needed to focus on right now, and there is a lot coming up in terms of the collective consciousness. There's a lot that is getting triggered right now around race, and there is also a lot around privilege. And when we talk about privilege, we're talking about those who are perceived to be at the top, the lawmakers, those who have a lot of money, that they are operating under one set of rules and the rest of you are operating under another. You will find that there is a lot going on in that situation where you're being told that there are certain things that you have to do and then they're doing just the opposite. And there is more information that's going to be coming out around the solstice about that, about a lot of the things that you have been told and how many of them are just simply not true. This is a form of disclosure that is coming out, and it's going to be very, very difficult for many of you to be able to mentally process the information because the depth at which a lot of this manipulation has been happening is almost impossible for some of you to fathom in the collective consciousness. Now, those of you who are hearing our words, you are slightly more prepared because you are vibrationally open to see things in another way. You are speaking with beings who are in another star system. So your perception of reality is slightly different than someone who may not believe in that at all, or who has a very fixed idea about how life is and they're not open at all. It's gonna be very shocking because they're gonna feel like they've been cracked open. Mentally and emotionally, and in some ways physically, all right, because it can have ramifications in the physical body. So it's going to be very, very difficult for others. So if you've been doing this work for a while, you are being called to really maintain your frequency and stand in your light to be the way shower for those around you, to show others that there is another way of being. And this is done not necessarily by you preaching or sharing information, although that can, the sharing of information can happen, but really it's about you just living from your heart-centered space, for holding compassion while others are going through their own process. Now, April was a time for you to deal with some of the emotional stuff that was coming up. A lot of the fears about your health, your well-being, about your suppression of rights, a lot of control, manipulation, safety, security, all that was coming up for you to deal with at the emotional level, preparing you for this time coming up so that you could deal with the mental aspect of it. So when you get to June, July, you're really gonna have to monitor your thoughts. What thoughts are you having in your mind? What's the inner critic talking about? You dealt with the more tender aspect of it first, because in a dualistic universe, in the process of manifestation, the feminine always comes first, all right? What you call feminine, your emotional state would fall under that heading, if you want, or that aspect of polarity. So you're dealing with that emotional turmoil first so that you can have clearer thoughts, all right? It's going to be very difficult for you to do it the other way around, to deal with the masculine aspect of the thought, and then most of you would just be inclined to stuff the emotional component. So the emotions came up first. And now you're dealing with more of the way that you're thinking about things, the way that you're processing. Because when you start from a different energetic, emotional, vibrational foundation, your thoughts are going to be different. The quality of your thoughts will be higher. So you had to purge and clear some of that so you could have a higher quality of thought. Now, maintenance of frequency is going to become very, very important. There are lots of stories going around about, you know, what this person said. By one group, it will be interpreted one way because that suits their filters, their programs, their perception of reality, and the other group, if you will, because we're giving you a polarized viewpoint here, and because it's a dualistic universe, this is how you set it up. You've got red, you've got blue, you've got good, bad, you've got the elite, the suppressed. So there's always this dualistic stance, and there will be those that will feel very oppressed, and they will look at someone, and it doesn't matter which side they're coming from, they will look at one person and they will interpret it the way that their filters are coloring the information, and the other side will have a completely different viewpoint. And you think, how can this be? How can we watch the same thing, the same information, and have such a vastly different impression of what was said and what's gone on? So this is what we also want you to be aware of, that there are very few things on this planet and in this universe that are truths. And we're talking about absolute truth. And those things are what you consider to be universal laws. They are the foundation upon which your dimensional structure is built. And the rest is all colored by perspective. All right, so if you can keep that in mind, that it's all colored by perspective, that will help you in the moment to have compassion for someone else. Not to immediately want to strike out at them because you're feeling threatened, but being open and curious about what filters they might have, or what belief systems they might have, or what wounds they might carry that need to be healed, or that you can perhaps show up for them in a way that will allow them to raise their frequency and see things in a different light. And when we say this, we also are saying this in such a way as to not make another wrong. All right, don't think that your perspective is better than another's, because it's not. It is just simply different. All right, your viewpoint is not right and theirs is not wrong. They're equally valid, they are just different. And you may choose to explore a particular frequency, and that is perfectly valid. Now, many of you will feel that you are damned to experience pain and suffering because that's where the collective is. But as you maintain your frequency, you can stand in a space of joy, happiness, bliss, grace, ease, compassion, no matter what's going on around you. And no one can take that away from you. All right, if you are fearful of your freedom, know that no one can change what you think and how you feel. And that is where your freedom lies. It is not in what is outside of you. And as you learn to hold that resonance and maintain that frequency, your external reality will begin to form around it. And this is what many don't want you to know, that you're exceptionally powerful in this regard, that you can shape and create your reality in any way that you wish, but you've got to be able to maintain your frequency. Because what most of you will ask for is something that is of a very high vibrational nature. And in order to see it reflected back as your reality, you have to be able to maintain the frequency. What most of you will do is pulse it out, say, I want this very high vibrational thing, and you can't sustain it, and so you drop out, you go down to lower frequencies, and then you are not able to sustain it, and you think, oh, this manifestation thing doesn't really work. But really, it's like building up a muscle, all right? You've got to practice, you've got to repeat the activity in order to build up that stamina. And it is the same thing with the maintenance of frequency. So the more you practice coming back to your heart center, the more you imagine yourself in alignment with the frequencies that you are seeking, whether you say, I am that thing, or I wonder what it would feel like to be that thing, the more you imagine it, the more you start to enliven your field with that energy, you start to pulse it out. And then anything that is unlike that frequency starts to come up so that it can be healed, so that it can be released, so that you can sustain the frequency that you're asking for. So as you move forward here with the maintenance of frequency, what we would also say is put your energy into the things that you want to see in the world rather than the things that you want to abolish. When you want to extinguish something, what you're doing is wanting to make it separate from you. You don't like it, you're judging it, you want to stamp it out. That is going to keep you in a loop with it.
because that is a part of universal energy, and you cannot permanently make that something that is separate from you. In essence, what it does is it cuts off half of your source light. It cuts off half of your flow of source energy. So what we would say is to take your energy out of those things that you perhaps are not keen on lending your energy to, all right? You're not trying to extinguish it. You're just taking your energy from it. And like a house of cards, as you start to pull the bottom cards out, it will start to collapse. And that's what others are hoping that you don't recognize either. Those that are in control of manipulating the situation, they are hoping that you don't wake up to the fact that you can just simply take your energy out and put it into something else. All of the things that you see in your world in terms of your governments, your rules, your regulations, you've just agreed to those. At any moment, you could take your energy out and just start putting it into something else. And it really is that simple. And that is about you making a choice and standing in your own power, all right? Being conscious of where you're vibrating and then making a choice to consciously direct your energy. And again, it's not about extinguishing something else. It's about putting it towards something that you want to build. And that will make all the difference in the world. Because when you want to extinguish something, again, as we said, you're staying in a loop with it. And that's just going to perpetuate this sense of your dualistic nature. It's the light against the dark. It's the dark against the light. And as the two have fought for many, many eons on your planet, in Atlantis, in Lemuria, as these aspects came together to extinguish the other, it just perpetuated the game. And so you're looking to rise above the game. You're working towards an awareness of yourself as a being that is both light and dark. Both are aspects of source energy. And so you're looking to that higher perspective of unity, of oneness. And sometimes, even with the light, the thought is that it must extinguish the dark. And that is no better than the dark wanting to extinguish the light. It will keep you in the game. So pull your energy out of that and put it towards building something that is more unifying and that brings both sides together, more sense of wholeness and completeness. So as you move into June and July, this is going to be really important for you. There will be many people who will have their belief systems challenged. They'll feel that they're triggered, they're activated by much of what is coming out in the public eye. And for you, you know, you may have the very same issues going on, maybe not at the level that others have it. Maybe for you, it's on a scale of 1 to 10, maybe a 2. But as you plug into the collective consciousness, it might go up to a 6 or 7. And so it can feel a little bit intense. And so your practice, your maintenance of frequency is about grounding, heart centering, and then setting the intention. How do you want to feel in this moment? Your feeling state is not determined on the external world. It is determined by the choice that you make internally. All right. In other words, you don't have to wait for something to happen outside of you in order to feel a particular way. If you want to feel a particular way, feel it right here and now. I wonder what it would feel like to be happy. What would that feel like? It might have been a while since you did it. All right. Since you've had that feeling. But just imagine what that would feel like in your body. And then you start to get that energy moving, and then your external reality starts to reflect it back to you, and it reinforces that feeling. The external is not the generator of that feeling, all right? Your desire for the experience of that frequency is what generates it in your external reality, all right? So we'll leave you here, but really, with maintaining your frequency, it's just about practice. Don't beat yourself up if you fall out, all right? Just keep coming back. Just recognize, I've fallen out. I've got myself into a bit of a huff. I'm not feeling very good. I feel very sad or depressed. And when you're ready, you can make a new choice. Don't beat yourself up for wanting to sit on the couch for an hour and do nothing. All right. What will happen is you'll process through that and you'll start to feel bored. And then you can say, I know I can choose a new frequency. And then you do. And so you move on. All right. So be kind to yourselves and be kind to others, because know that they're going through a challenging time. And some of you have a few more tools in your toolbox and you've been going at this for a while. So just remember that and see if you can't hold a space of more compassion and grace. And as you do that for others, you'll find that you do that more for yourself as well. All right. And that life just gets easier. You feel more peaceful, more calm, and then it is easier for you to maintain the frequencies that you wish. So as always, dear ones, know that we are around, we are nearby, we are always with you in essence. We hear you every time you call on us, and until we hear from you, we'll be watching, we'll be waiting, and we'll be sending many, many well wishes. So thank you so much for joining me. If you enjoyed this channeling, feel free to pass it along. It might help someone else who is going through a challenging time today. And if you'd like to experience more channeling from the Pleiadian Collective, join us live during our monthly calls, The Pleiadian Perspective. You'll find more information on that over on our website at higherfrequencies.net. I'm sending you many thoughts of love, grace, health, ease, and abundance. And until I connect with you again soon, be well. If you enjoyed this channeling and you'd like to experience more from the Pleiadian Collective, be sure to check out our live online group sessions, The Pleiadian Perspective. For more information or to register for an upcoming event, visit our website at higherfrequencies.net.